On my main channel, I get a lot of questions on how to create a good short. So in this video, I will show you how I create my gaming shorts. I'll go over the editing process, but I also will talk about why I make certain decisions. And also just give a lot of tips and tricks during this video. I'm making a Valorant short, but of course you can use the same tricks for any game. So the first thing you want is a vertical sequence. Click on File, click on New, click on Sequence, then go to Digital SLR, 1080p, and click on 30fps. When you go to Settings, you can change the FPS. I record with 60fps, so I'm gonna click on that. And then you want to reverse the frame size. So instead of 920, I'm gonna use 180 here, and I'm gonna use 920 here. And now you got a vertical sequence. When you drag a clip in, you're probably gonna see this pop up, but you just gotta click on Keep Existing Settings. And then just scale the clip in the sequence. I like to do it like this. From now on, it's all about flow. Everyone got a different editing flow, but I will show you mine. What I like to do is record my voiceover first, and then do the rest. So let's do that now. You can record a voiceover by clicking on this microphone over here. And here the first big tip from Mr. Lowlander. If you want to make a good short, it has to be quick after each other. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna cut the voice as most to the right as possible. Another OP ult with strong grenade combo. Breeze. Also here, I stop here with the S so this can go away. This way it's fast after each other.
On Breeze. Another OP ult with strong grenade combo.
So what I try to explain is that a good short has to keep the attention of the viewer. By cutting out those small silences, the pace is a lot faster. And here another tip about the same subject. So after I spoke this, I go to the most edge of the clip. Cut it. And also on the other side. And you think, oh, this is good. No, it's not good, my friends. You can go zoom in even faster.
Hide.
You see, even this little gap can go away. Other side.
First.
Okay, other side is good. And just slide it back to the old
combo.
Clip.
First.
So now that the voice recording is done, we can start adding the clips. So a thing that is very important is that you want to grab the attention at the start of the video. So we're gonna do that by adding a clip of a kill, of course. That grabs attention, you know? So what my idea is, of course, I'm not an expert, but what my idea is, text grabs attention. So the first,
how to retake B with Killjoy on Breeze.
So what we say at the start, we're gonna use text for that. And after you got the text, you got another dopamine rush by seeing an easy kill.
Another OP ult.
You see?
With strong.
So that's my ID. So we got here, comes text, and then, bam, two dopamine kicks in only 4 seconds. So that's how you grab attention. How do I make text? Well, easy as that. So what you're gonna do is go to File, go to New, go to Legacy Tile, and then just start it. Find a cool letter type. I always use this one, but it's personal preference, you know. The reason why I like this letter type is because it's in your face, and I want it to be more in your face. So instead of white, I like to use green. You can also do yellow, green, yellow, and light blue. They are in your face colors, so use those. And I like shadows. Shadows, 100%. Make it as big as possible, because then it's more in your face. And then what you want to do is you look at these and make sure it's in the middle. Yes, this works. So this is the text that we're gonna use. The problem now is that this is still very boring. I'm gonna let the letters pop in one by one. It's a very cool trick to keep the attention there. So I'm gonna go to the effects, find here the crop effect, put the crop effect on the title. Now you're gonna count the amount of words you got. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That's a lot. Normally I have less, but okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, then move everything to the right. So what you're gonna do is click on the title, go to effects, then because we use the crop effect on the title, you now have a crop effect here. Bottom, go up, then right, go to the right. Now we only have the how. You can zoom in.
How to
here I say the 2 already, so then I push this to the right. Go up and go to the right again. And now I have the 2. Here I start with retake.
I think you got a drill by now. Do this with every title and then you end up looking something like this.
And voila, we got it.
How to retake B with Killjoy on Breeze.
So what we have now We have a beautiful intro with grabs the attention with text.
How to retake B with Killjoy on Breeze.
And after that, we have a kill that also releases dopamine and you want to watch more.
Another OP ult with strong grenade combo.
Even though the kill has nothing to do with the video, it grabs attention. So after that, we just gonna edit.
Combo. First, stand against this wall and place your ult.
First, stand against the wall and place your ult. I think that's this part of the clip.
Good. As you see on the minimap, there's only one place enemy players can hide.
So now, we're gonna do a little bit with the size.
There's only one place enemy players can hide.
Size? Okay, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna use an arrow, because if I just show this clip, it's maybe not really clear what place I mean. So I'm gonna use an arrow I downloaded from Google. if you type arrow, you find this arrow. It's very easy. It's black. I don't even like black. It's better if you have a green arrow, but I'm too lazy to make it green. And black also works fine. So we're gonna angle it so that it's obvious. Now I could use this.
As you see on the minimap, there's only one place enemy players can hide.
So I can use this, and back in the day I used this, but it's a little bit a boring shot. And to make it a little bit more excited, I'm gonna flick the arrow. So what I'm just gonna do is simply zoom in and cut some parts out. And now that I've cut some part out, I can delete the health of it, reposition some. And now let's see if it's too much or too less.
As you see on the minimap, there's only one place enemy players can hide. So
it works. This one just a little bit more to the right.
Ult. As you see.
And this one also a little bit more to the right.
Place your ult. As you see on the minimap, there's only one place enemy players can hide.
So now it's a little bit more excited to watch, if you understand what I mean. So after that, we have this part.
Can hide. So we're gonna learn a lineup for that spot.
I don't really have a clip for that. So instead of using a clip, we're gonna use another dopamine kick for the viewer again. So now we're gonna take like a cool shot, a cool kill we made. This is a clip, a flick I made, a beautiful flick. I died immediately after the flick, but that part, of course, we're not gonna show. Just gonna show that part. Yes. So we're gonna cut this out and we're gonna make it smaller, put it in, and just gonna zoom in here again. And now we have another grab attention.
Hide. So we're gonna learn a lineup for that spot.
A grab attention clip. So that's good. And now I've added all my clips. Very good. So one thing that's important if you want to grow with YouTube Shorts is that the viewer will have to know that it's your short. And you have to have something that is unique. And I did it with an outro. I tried to make a very unique outro. And that is this. This is always what I say at the end of a short, unless I make a loop. But more about that later.
Be main. Subscribe for more horizontal and vertical content.
It's very unique, and that's the reason if people see this, they know it's my short. And that's very nice if you want to grow with YouTube Shorts. So I used an outro. It was bad at first. Like, wait, I can show you. This is how you do it now, but I can show you how I did it back in the day. So what I did back in the day, I made this as outro. It doesn't look good. But what I always did is I make it bigger. Then I will click here. Click on rotation. Then go to 1/3. Rotate to the right. Like this. And then go to all the way to the end and rotate to the left. And this used to be my outro.
Main. Subscribe for more horizontal and vertical content.
It's bad. I know it's bad, but at least people knew it were my shorts. And that's how I got my first, I think literally my first like 20,000 subscribers because of this outro. They know this is me. And that's why it worked. But I changed it now. I use this outro now. What I do is the same. It's still bad. I know it can be better. I'm too lazy to ask like someone to make a good outro, but I use this. Then I use this. This someone made for me, so that's, I'm very lucky with that. But he made this for me. I will put it on top of it. Remove the audio. Make it smaller. And make it bigger. And do it like above the fish. The arrows are important in my opinion, because with the arrows you know the viewer is gonna look down, and they look down to the subscribe button. So that's something to keep in mind. Subscriber thing. I could like remove this, like this, make this the outro, but it's still a little bit, I don't know. So I use this one on top of it, and also this one I make bigger. How do I do it? I click on position and scale. when I have my timeline at the start, then I do my timeline at the end. Make this bigger, a little bit down, and now
subscribe for
it
more
grows.
Horizontal and vertical content.
And this is how you make a short. But before I end, I want to show you another possibility. Instead of doing this as outro, you could also make a loop. How do you do that?
If there's still enemies alive, they are probably at B main.
This part of the video, you're gonna do at the start. So instead of this first part, you're gonna remove this, then copy this. By holding your Alt key, you're gonna copy this. Place it over here. Place it further and back. And just place the script over here. And now you got a loop. So when I click on loop now, at the end of this, we're gonna start at this, and the background is exactly the same. Just look at this.
Enemies alive, they are probably at B main. How to retake B with Killjoy on Breeze.
You see, and that's how you make a loop. But instead of a loop, I prefer this as outro. Some videos work better with a loop, some videos work better with an outro. It depends. So let's go through my short step by step one more time. First, the text to grab the attention of the viewer.
How to retake B with Killjoy on Breeze.
Check, I got the attention of the viewer. Then a dopamine kick. Those two things are very important. If you have that, then the viewer is gonna watch your short longer.
Another
and that's in this case the kill.
OP ult with strong grenade combo. First.
Okay, good. After that, the first clip. It's just like the setup.
First, stand against this wall and place your ult. As you see on the minimap.
Here, instead of having a boring picture, I use the knippering of the arrow. It's a little bit more easier to watch.
There's only one place enemy players can hide. So we're gonna learn the lineup for that.
A small dopamine rush in between the video again. Always nice.
Sentry gun ability with the blue.
Again, the flickering of the arrow. It's to grab the attention. Another very, very important thing that you have to remember is that the outro no longer than 2 seconds. If you make this, I could have like extended this, you know, and maybe say more. But if you do that, the retention of your video drops a lot. So don't make the outro more than 2 seconds, otherwise your retention rate will go down and you get less views. And this is it. This is how you make a short. Oh yeah, last few steps. If you want to render, click on File, click on Export, click on Media. I use format H.264 and then high bitrate. Then click on this, use maximum depth. Also this, render at maximum depth. Scroll down, FRPass, I use 2PASS. And target bitrate, I would say 16. That's a good one. And then just click on export, and you have to wait for a while.
And this is it. I hope you learned something, and I see you in the next one. Peace.